Recently, I got to go to Deserres twice. We also went to Gwartzman's, and then I finally got to go to Wonderpen's. And then just a few days later, my Ferris Wheel Press July color arrived. And so this is going to be a very long swatching video where I get to swatch out all the new colors from all the brands. I'm going to start by just opening everything up. This was actually filmed about 2 weeks ago, so you've seen some of these colors in pieces. You've seen the Ferris Wheel Press inks on my page, but I did want to put this video out because it was a really fun video to film, and there are some cool color swatches in it of the Ferris Wheel Press ink. And two, there were some really odd pigments that Rosa Galleries does in single pigments that I'd never seen before in a paint brand. And so some of the colors that I picked were colors that I knew I wanted, like the gray and black colors, and then others were just colors that looked interesting. I'm actually going to start with the fountain pens because I've been waiting to open these. And so the first one up is from the Ferris Wheel Press Poison Envy collection, and these arrived literally just before I walked out the front door. So I did ink this pen just before I left the house, but I didn't actually play around with it. I wanted to have it inked so that the pen had time for the ink to run through the feed, because it was a medium nib pen and the ink is very sparkly. This is part of their Once Upon a Time collection of inks, and it's called Poison Envy, and it is so sparkly. And I love how the green just sort of floats out of it. So I did a writing sample of how the nib writes just on a card, and I was so happy with this pen. I didn't have a medium nib pen in my collection. I tend to stick fine, extra fine. And then when we were at Wonder Pens, I saw the Lamy Vista. I have two of the Jinhao 777 pens, which are Lamy Vista, Lamy Safari dupe pens. They were my two first fountain pens, and I didn't actually know Lamy made a clear pen. I've wanted a clear pen for a little bit, and so the fact that I could get a clear pen in a style that I already knew I liked meant that I decided that it was time to finally get something clear. And so I ended up getting the Lamy Vista in broad, which is the largest nib that I think I'd want in my collection. It's large enough that I can use it for titles, but like small enough that it's still practical to use in a notebook, I find, for headers and titles and all those fun things. And I've had it for probably 3 weeks now, and it works really well. And the shimmer really comes out in it. The shimmer still comes out in the medium, but it is significantly more fun to use sparkly ink than something just a little bit bigger. I did end up comparing the two. And you can definitely see the like line difference between the Ferris Wheel Press medium and the Lamy in broad. I have been using both. I have been daily driving both for about 3 weeks, and both have been being carried around for pretty much 3 weeks solid, and I do really like both. And now we get to do the fun stuff, which is swatching paints. There were a lot of colors. I'm not sure how I feel about the Rosa paints. They're significantly more opaque than I thought they'd be. That being said, I think I need to play around with them more to figure out what I like and dislike about them. And I will leave all the information to paints and everything in the description below. I know that Wednesdays are normally Paint Your Style, but there was no Paint Your Style challenge this week, and so I decided that instead of having no video this week, it would be nicer to have a haul and swatching video of some fun new colors. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.